I'm Gab, he's Jules. Blue skies over West London, blue skies over Madrid, with the Killian has landed. It's all official. The Modric may be staying as well. I don't know why I'm putting definite articles in front of their names, but seems appropriate. But we have to start with this huge story breaking in the Premier League. It's a story that's actually dates back to March.
Story in a way. Yeah.
But because of the secrecy, non-disclosure, blah, 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 which the Premier League do everything for good reason, they say, this was only really broken wide open by the Times on Tuesday.
Yeah.
It is a little complicated. I have a Q&A explainer up on the website. So you can delve more into that. In a nutshell, Manchester City, the champions of the Premier League, are suing the Premier League. Now, we say suing, they're not actually going to court, because under the Premier League rules, they're going to go to an arbitration panel over this, and it's going to be three dudes are going to decide. One picked by the Premier League, one picked by City, and the other two kind of agreed upon by both. But essentially, the core issue why they're doing this is when clubs receive sponsorship income from related parties or associated parties, as the Premier League like to call them, just to be different, as we've explained in the past. If they're related parties, they are assessed at what they call fair market value. So in other words, this is the reason why they can't do what your friends at Paris Saint-Germain did. Yeah, there you go. There's no like 200 million. Etihad couldn't pay City 200 million to sponsor their shirts. Etihad, of course, the flag carrier from Abu Dhabi, City owned by members of the royal family of Abu Dhabi. So there's obviously a related party.
Yeah.
What they do is if they put in a 200 million sponsorship of City, the Premier League or UEFA, they go and they say, all right, we think this sponsorship is inflated.
Yeah.
So we're going to assess it at what we call fair market value. They don't assess it. They get a bunch of nerds with analytics who look at this and say, okay, what's a comparable club to City? How much do they get from unrelated parties for a similar sponsorship? We think instead of 200 million, it should be worth 30 million or 50 million or whatever it is, right? And they do the same thing incidentally with transfers. So it's not like New York City FC can pay 200 million to take Calvin Phillips away and then City all of a sudden, haha, we've made 200 million, right? They can see through that. So City are arguing that this violates competition law. They're arguing that a sponsor, even if it's a related sponsor, heck, it could even be another company owned by Mansour or Abu Dhabi United Group, they should be allowed to put in as much money as they want. This is going to go to an arbitration panel. Most of the Premier League clubs are siding with the Premier League, obviously, because they passed this by they need a two-thirds majority. If City, some Premier League clubs reportedly are, Newcastle is one, reportedly Chelsea as well, possibly Villa, will back, are expressing letters of support to City.
Yeah.
They're backing City's position. And we'll see how this turns out. The main implication in this is twofold. One is that if this law is struck down, theoretically, but I don't think that'll happen. I'll explain why later. City or Newcastle could just pump as much money as they want into the club. And that part would go out the window, and then costs would rise, presumably, and football would become harder to sustain financially. The other big implication is if it's not illegal to inflate sponsorships, then a lot of the 115 charges that City are facing in November, those would probably go out the window, because it might have been illegal at the time, presumably. Yeah. But, you know, it's kind of like if you get done for marijuana possession and while you're awaiting trial, marijuana is decriminalized, a judge isn't going to throw the book at you.
Yeah, I think it's an incredible move from City, to be honest. Really bold. I'm not sure if it's a good look on them or not. It's clearly linked, like you said, to the 115 charges that we're still waiting to see if they will get sanctioned, find guilty or not find guilty. I've got a few issues with it, in the sense that they said in their statement that they might be forced to cut all the money they give to the community in Manchester because of that, which I find there's a touch of hypocrisy a little bit in this whole thing, right? Because they bought the club and saying, we're going to re-energize all the area and stadium, the community would be great. They've done a lot of amazing work there. And now, 15 years on or whatever, how many long it is, they're saying like, well, actually, we might need to cut this. And there's a few things like that that I'm not too comfortable with.
100%. We're going to delve into this more on the Gab and Juls podcast. But just as a reminder, City made a profit of £80 million last year. They made a profit of about £40 million a year before that. And this was in a scenario where the fair market view, the fair market value rules had already been introduced. So that was with the sponsorships assessed at fair market value. And of course, as far as this being non-competitive, making it difficult for City to compete, obviously they've won 6 of the 7 Premier League titles.